So, very good evening to all of you. I hope I am clearly audible and visible. I hope I am clearly audible and visible to all of you. Okay. Just a minute, just a minute. So I welcome you all to the session. This is a short and crisp session for your important images. We will revise images from all important chapters, which can come in your upcoming FMG exams, which are going to be held in August and September. Okay. So, a brief introduction about Unacademy platform, those who are new to this platform. What you all get in this platform once you get a subscription, you are entitled for Unacademy Plus courses, and daily live classes are conducted of all 19 subjects for your NEET PG exams. And there are separate batch courses, structured courses for FMG exams also. Then there are live tests, and you will have unlimited access to all the sessions which you have attended in the form of recordings. Recordings are available on the platform itself. Good evening, Dilpreet. Good evening, Robin, Daruni. Good evening. And this is how your final subscription page looks like. And you can select the duration according to your need, 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. The most recommended one is 12-month subscription because that comes to be very handy. And in the final subscription page, you can apply this referral code of mine, Dr. Vishwajit-YT, to get a 10% discount. So you will have access to all the courses, not only my subject. You will have access to all the live sessions running for that duration for which subscription has been taken. And you can watch the sessions even after end of the session. You can revise the sessions again and again. Okay. And a very good news for all FMG students as well as students who are going to give their upcoming AIIMS, PGI and JIPAR exams. I am conducting free live sessions both for FMG segment as well as your upcoming AIIMS, PGI and JIPMER segment. So every day the session for FMG exams will be held from 5 to 6 p.m. and this will be a sort of test and discussion where topic-wise discussion will be done for FMG exams from 5 to 6 p.m. daily, and the dates are 25th to 29th of May. Okay, and for upcoming central exams, that is AIIMS, PGI and JIPMER, the test and discussion program will be conducted from 8 to 9 p.m. For all the students, it will be available. You can watch the free live sessions and you can take the benefit of your revising forensic subject. Okay, so tell all your friends, whoever is going to give their FMG exams, so that all the 10 to 12 questions which come from this subject in your FMG exams or other exams, you will have a good revision of those areas. And all the questions will be prepared by me only. So in Unacademy segment, what we will do in this forensic test and discussion, you will first answer the question. There is a 30-second poll window which will pop up in your screen. You will first solve the question and then we will shortly discuss that question along with all probable questions which can come from that root question. Okay. So save the dates, save the time. And all the sessions are free live sessions. 5 hours for your FMG segment and 5 hours for our upcoming AIIMS, PGI and JIPMER exams. Okay. So let us quickly see some images, and you will be answering the images. The images will be shown to you and you have to just answer what the image tells you. let us quickly revise some important aspects through images. Identify the injury which is shown in the image. What comes to your mind if you are shown this image and directly asked what is this injury? So today I am not giving you options. Today you have to tell me the answer directly. Just like a spotting which is held in MBBS exams. See how your thought process. I am just asking the injury over scalp. Okay, identify the injury over scalp. Injury over scalp region. Is it an incised wound or lacerated wound? A leading question. Is it a lacerated wound? Yes or no? So you can answer like this. Yes or no? So I have simplified your question. Is it a lacerated wound? Yes or no? So what are leading questions? Questions answerable in yes or no manner. Yes, this is a lacerated wound. Why? Because see, the margins are totally irregular. And over this area, you can see the tissue bridges also. Over this ticked area, you can see connections between the two edges. So how do you say a wound to be a lacerated wound? Based on irregular margins and based on presence of tissue bridges or tissue connections. So what are tissue bridges? Connections between the two edges. So a lacerated wound has got connections. But if you use a knife, what will happen? Everything will be clean cut and there will be no tissue bridges. This is how we easily differentiate between LW and IW. IW is incised wound and LW is lacerated. Okay, so this is a very good image of your lacerated wound. So over the scalp region, how the injury looks? Incised looking lacerated wounds are seen over scalp region. Why? Because bone is just beneath the scalp layer. So this is a very good image of your incised looking lacerated wound seen over scalp and also over anterior tibial region, that is called shin, because bone is just beneath the skin in these areas. Okay, yes, very good Dilpreet, very good. Identify this injury. I will give you options: pressure abrasion, impact abrasion, patterned abrasion. So out of these three abrasions, what will be your best answer out of A, B and C by looking at the injury? Options are given: pressure abrasion, impact abrasion or patterned abrasion. Go on, very good. So this is a very good image of your patterned abrasion. What is patterned abrasion? Suppose a moving vehicle has done an impact and after the impact the driver applied the brakes and there was a constant pressure over a body part. So these are patterns of brake pedal of a vehicle. So when there was road traffic accident of a vehicle, over the brake pedal there was impact of the leg of the driver, and due to constant pressure a pattern of these brake pedals could be seen. So yes, the best answer now will be patterned abrasions, because you can correlate exactly the impact has occurred over which area? Yes. Okay. Next question. Identify the postmortem change shown in the eye. Which postmortem change is being shown in your eyes? And second question will be, what will be your time since death? If you are shown this finding, what will be your time since death? Okay, very good. Irfan, Sattarshi, very good. No, not actually tardy spots. Yes, when eyes remain open after death, you can see these triangles. Two triangles on both sides of cornea. Tardy spots will be very pinpoint hemorrhages. So these are not tardy spots, okay? These are tachinoir formation in the eye. So in your exams, one of the exams, they have asked tachinoir is seen in which part of eye? Yes, this is sclera part of eye. So this is seen in sclera part of eye. So it occurs in those situations whenever eyes of a person are open at the time of death. So what happens is drying of the sclera occurs, and that leads to formation of two yellow colored triangular areas on both sides of cornea called as tachinoir. And the ideal time for this to get developed is 3 to 4 hours after death. So by looking at tardy spots, I can say yes, time since death will be 3 to 4 hours. Tardy spots will be something like very pinpoint hemorrhages, and mainly over subconjunctival area. Okay, pinpoint shape hemorrhages, and they are non-specific hemorrhages seen in different types of asphyxial deaths. Which are the specific hemorrhages seen in cases of drowning? Which specific hemorrhages are seen over lung surface in cases of drowning? And these are specific for drowning cases. What is the name of those hemorrhages? Which are specifically seen in drowning cases? And they are bigger in size as compared to tardy spots. They are small sized hemorrhages seen over subpleural location of lungs, mainly involves lower lobes. What is the name of that hemorrhage? That is called, yes, very good, Pultoff's hemorrhage. Now suppose this dead body was brought to me for autopsy. Instead of this tachinoir, what I am seeing is his whole eye is congested and there are hemorrhages, scleral hemorrhages, conjunctival hemorrhages are present. So these hemorrhages will suggest me which modality of death. So what I will suggest, what should be the cause of death if I see scleral hemorrhages and conjunctival hemorrhages? So my thought process will go towards, yes, the mechanism could be asphyxial deaths. So always remember, hemorrhages in eye suggest towards asphyxial deaths. Mainly which asphyxial deaths? Wherever large amount of pressure has been applied over neck, like ligature strangulation cases, like manual strangulation cases. So hemorrhages in eye mainly suggest either ligature strangulation, manual strangulation, wherever force is large. So next spotter. Identify the fracture. This is the fracture shown to you in the hyoid bone. First, identify the fracture. What is this fracture called? Name of the fracture. So where this arrow is pointing, this is showing you fracture of outer periosteum of hyoid bone. And you can see the movement of distal fractured fragment is inwards. You can very well see the movement of fractured fragment is inwards. So what is the name of this fracture? So it is called inward compression fracture. So in your ortho you must have read, na? How is a fracture named? A fracture is given called medial rotation fracture. How? When the distal fractured fragment is medially rotated. So here the distal fractured fragment is moving inwards. So the name is given as inward compression fracture. So by seeing this fracture, I can correlate, okay, these are mainly associated with throttling cases, also called as manual strangulation or throttling. But suppose this distal fractured fragment is moving outwards and I see a fracture of inner periosteum. Now what will be the fracture called when the distal fractured fragment is moving outwards? This will be outward compression fracture. And this is mainly associated with hanging cases. Hanging cases. Okay. And there are avulsion fractures also, also called tuck-tua fractures. They are not specific for a particular type of particular cause of death. There the fractured fragments can move in any direction, but usually the distal fractured fragment moves inwards and the fracture is of outer periosteum. Okay, so this is another question zone. So now they can ask you this question with the help of this image. So always keep this image in mind. Identify the injury first. Blunt injury, firearm injury, incised wound, lacerated wound. Whether it is incised wound, lacerated wound, or firearm wound, so what should be your answer out of ABC? This is a session for FMG exams only. Okay, Anamika. So this injury suggests firearm case. Why? Because you are seeing a central wound, entry wound, and surrounding this entry wound you can see all the things like blackening of skin margins. Then you can see tattooing and blackening is present around the entry wound. No, this is not shotgun. This is stippled appearance due to unburnt gunpowder particles. So correct answer to this question will be yes, this is a firearm wound and there is a central wound surrounded by blackening and tattooing. So the questions which they ask you, what will be the range of the firearm weapon? And your options will be given like contact shot, close shot, intermediate shot and distant shot. So what should be your answer? By looking at this wound, what should be your answer? So what is not given in this question is, and nothing has been given about singeing. So how will you say close shot, Dilpreet? For a close shot to be present, what should be present? Singeing, blackening and tattooing. Abhijit, I have an image of that beveling thing. I know the problematic areas. I have an image of beveling thing. Okay, it will come. So, correct answer to this question will be intermediate shot. So, basically in my FMG revision course, with the help of MCQs, one day I will revise all this area. Okay, and the exact thing, I have mentioned it in my Telegram group, the topics which will be covered each day. Like first day I'll be covering toxicology along with identification, then another day toxicology with thanatology. And you all can join my Telegram group in the name of FMT Concepts. When you search in Telegram, this is the name of the group and the link is available in my FB profile, everywhere, in my FB group. So correct answer to this question will be intermediate shot. When the wound will be a close shot? When singeing, blackening and tattooing, all three are present. So in our test and discussion course, no, we will simplify this area. This needs more time for understanding. Okay. Identify the type of asphyxial death. Identify the type of asphyxial death. I will give you options: choking, gagging, smothering. So what should be your answer out of A, B, C? Good evening, Rahul. Good evening. Yes, this is a very good image showing you obstruction of oronasopharynx. So, obstruction of oronasopharynx is called as gagging. And this obstruction can be done by the use of a handkerchief like this. So, this is a very good image showing you gagging. What is smothering? External compression of mouth and nose. By any means, by hands, by pillows. And Abhijit Chaudhary, this is your image, okay? You were asking for babbling. Now I know the problems where, the areas where you feel difficulty in understanding. So the question is, by seeing this image, identify whether it is entry wound or exit wound. So I will simplify this topic and you will understand it throughout your life. You will remember it throughout your life. First, put your answers in the chat window. Let me see whether it is entry wound or exit wound. This is the question. Anamika, entry. Okay. Dilpreet, entry. Irfan, exit. Inner table, beveled. Sana. Okay. So see, before telling the answer, let me draw a skull bone. Our skull bone has got two tables, outer table and inner table. Okay. Outer table and inner table. Now suppose a weapon has been fired from this direction and a bullet is coming to hit your skull bone. What is the movement of the bullet? Like this. This is the direction of the bullet. Now this bullet enters the outer table and the outer table says, I have the support of inner table. So I will not show bevelling. But inner table, when this bullet strikes the inner table says, beneath me is the brain matter and the brain is not able to support me. So bevelling will occur over my surface. So with respect to movement of bullet, outer table has the support of inner table in entry wound, but inner table is unsupported. So always remember this simple line: unsupported table shows bevelling. Unsupported skull table shows bevelling, and you will never mark your answer wrong. So with respect to movement of bullet, outer table has the support of inner table, inner is unsupported, so inner table shows bevelling. And this is how inner table bevelling looks like. Bevelling means chipping of a part of the skull bone. Like this. Okay. All this is beveled area. So if they have to show you bevelling, they will have to show you base of the skull bone. So you can see these bony projections everywhere. So whenever base of the skull is shown to you, okay, inner table bevelling is being shown to me. So inner table bevelling. Inner table is unsupported structure in entry wound, so it will show bevelling. This is the another way to solve this questions. So if they have to show you bevelling of outer table, they will have to show you skull vault. So with respect to movement of bullet in exit wound, suppose now the bullet is coming out. Now this and inner table has got the support of outer table, but outer table so says outside me there is nothing to support me. So again now beveling will be seen over outer table because the outer table is unsupported. So beveling basically occurs with respect to movement of the bullet in entry and exit wounds. I hope it is clear for everyone. Identify the type of hanging. Which type of hanging is this? Options are typical or atypical. Is it typical or atypical? So typical hanging is defined as whenever the knot position is over mid occipital region, or we say midline back of neck. So whenever knot is over mid occipital region, this is called typical hanging. Not anywhere else other than mid occipital will be called as atypical. Not anywhere else. Is referred to as atypical hanging. So this is a very good image of typical hanging. This is the image of your typical hanging because the knot of the ligature material is over mid occipital region. So it's time to end the session. So all of you remember the dates, 25th to 29th of May. So I will try to cover maximum number of MCQs. Every day like about 20 to 30 MCQs. So you will have a good revision of all the important topics. Hanging is the most common method of suicide. Most common method of suicide in India is hanging. So timings for FMG exams students will be 5 to 6 p.m. daily. 1 hour for 5 days, that means 5 hours in total. And for upcoming AIIMS exam people and PGI and JIPMER students, the timings will be 8 to 9, where all the new pattern AIIMS questions will be discussed. Topics I have mentioned in my Telegram group. Okay, you can go through that image file. Like on first day, I will cover on 25th, I will cover your identification and toxicology part. On 26th, for FMG segment, I am telling. I will cover your toxicology again with thanatology and like that. I have divided. The whole course will be revised. And for PG students, it will be a mixed bag of questions. And this is free for all the students, free live session in the form of a special class. So to enroll for the class, Telegram link, actually the Telegram group name is FMT Concepts by Dr. Vishwajit Singh. Okay. Or if you go to my FB group or FB page, the link is there in the first page, first or second page itself. So to all of you, try to enroll for the course, okay, for FMG courses also and for PG TND also. So for enrolling to the course, you will have to go to my profile in Unacademy, and there you can look at this segment, upcoming special classes, upcoming special class, and there you will see whole schedule. So you can enroll for all 5 days schedule, and this is a free live session for all the students. So tell all your friends to take the benefit, okay, to revise this subject. Okay, so thank you very much. Time to end the session. I have another session right now after 1 minute itself. So I'll be ending the session. Bye bye. Thank you.